Hello, my dear students. Welcome to Fluid Mechanics Lecture Series. I am your Soma Miss. So this is the first class in Fluid Mechanics Lecture Series. The topic for today's discussion is, why do you want to study fluid mechanics? That is just because we are living in an environment of air and water, and almost all the things what we are doing have some connections to the laws of fluid mechanics. Some applications we can understand very easily, whereas some applications we cannot understand at all. So let us start our discussion from our daily life. So all of you might have used a shower at least once while taking bath. Have you ever thought of the design factors which makes the showering experience comfortable? So do you know the size of the nozzle and the pressure of the water are the two factors which rules the comfort? So these two factors are governed by the laws of fluid mechanics. Now consider taking out lotion from a bottle by applying pressure. Though cream is a fluid, it will not flow easily as water. So that is just because of the fluid property that is called viscosity, which always resists the fluid flow. So when we want to apply this cream over your skin, you need to apply a force tangential to the surface. So the amount of force you need to apply here is related to the viscosity of the cream. So for example, oil can be applied easily, whereas cream requires more effort. Now a question, have you ever thought of why dirt comes out easily from a cloth while using detergent and hot water? That is just because higher temperature reduces the viscosity, while the presence of detergent reduces the fluid property called surface tension. So these are the two properties which resist the easy movement of the water into the fabrics of the cloth. Now consider the application of fluid mechanics in weather forecast. Movement of the cyclone can be modeled as fluid flow. Now please watch this video. The video shows the movement of the cyclone and wind velocity that is also available, and a color scale is used to differentiate different velocities. So here the maximum velocity is coming is 49 miles per hour, whereas minimum velocity is coming as 12 miles per hour. This fluid flow modeling helps us to predict when the cyclone hit the land and thereby reducing its catastrophic effect. Now just consider the application of fluid mechanics in flood simulation. So nowadays we have been experiencing flood quite often. So it becomes necessary to identify the area which are flooded by these severe events. So the principle of fluid mechanics can be used to model the flood and thereby delineating the areas which can be affected by the flood as indicated in this video. So the video shows simulation of 2018 flood in Periyar River. So this figure represents the digital elevation model of Periyar River. So the video also shows how and when the flood arrived at the area of interest. Now consider the application of fluid mechanics in medical field. Just think of a natural system in your body where fluid mechanics have a major role. So it is nothing but human heart, a pump and piping system which works for decades continuously from your birth till your death. So nowadays heart diseases are very common by the reduction in the flow area due to the deposit of cholesterol. Here also fluid mechanics have a significant role. Let us consider role of fluid mechanics in power generation. Windmills are designed in such a way that even slight movement of the air causes the blades to rotate. Similarly, the water which is stored in dams or reservoir can be used to generate electric power. So the potential energy or the pressure energy that is available is converted into mechanical energy and then to electric energy by proper movement of water through turbines. So this is also a very important application of fluid mechanics. Nowadays, fluid flow modeling can be used to design the shape of automobiles. So you can see here, this is a racing car and this is a passenger car. Fluid flow modeling can be used to design the shapes in such a way that in both cases, air resistance is minimum. Nowadays, aerodynamic shapes are used in the design of aircraft, ships, submarines, etc. So these shapes are derived from natural things like birds and fishes. Very comprehensive flow modeling is needed before finalizing the shapes. So from these discussions, we could see that fluid mechanics have a major role not only in our daily applications, but also in almost all fields of technological development. Hope you understood the importance of studying fluid mechanics. Fluid mechanics has three divisions. One is fluid statics, the second one is fluid kinematics, and third one is fluid dynamics. In fluid statics, we are considering the behavior of the fluid under rest, whereas in fluid kinematics, we are considering the fluid motion without considering the forces which causes the fluid motion. Whereas in fluid dynamics, we are considering the behavior of the fluid during motion by considering the forces which causes the motion. So all the fluid mechanics classes are prepared based on your syllabus, and you can see that in my subsequent videos. So don't forget to drop the comments and share and subscribe. For the time being, it is enough. Thank you.